Thank you. seats for adults, children's life vests, or anybody else who might think they're under 90 pounds. Children's life vests back in the corner. We think they've dried out for this morning, so we should be good to go. Checking to see if anybody's listening. No smoking on board, not even the electronic variety. And once we get to a stop, go out of a stop, please stay seated while we're doing it and out. I don't want anybody to get bumped and get hurt, so please stay seated. How many mothers on board? Happy Mother's Day from the water test. Street Fisheries is an award-winning seafood restaurant, and they have a lot of other good things besides seafood. Next house on the left, the most expensive house out here, $50 million. Looks like the Jungle Queen is pretty well loaded today. If they're looking down at you saying, I get about a 2.5 hour ride, for the same price you guys paid for a hop on, hop off all day at night. They're envious. Is going to be by how many pilings. That's going to be a pretty good size house. It'll be interesting to see if they go back to the South Florida design or they imitate the more modern design here on the ring. This is a fun place if you got a small boat to hang out on Saturdays and Sundays. We call it the Redneck Riviera and Deer Camp Highway. They, as you can see, all they have to do is step off the boat shallow enough, they can just sit there. The house we just passed on the right is the White House of Fort Lauderdale. It's named after the White House in D.C. for obvious reasons. Looks a lot like it. Big difference though, nobody has knocked this fence and got inside, unlike the one at D.C.
Five. This is the train for the Holly.
Okay, folks, next stop is going to be number five. Let's check and see if you're listening. Number five, transfer point to go to Hollywood. Next point to Hollywood is going to be at 2:30, yep. Next port to Hollywood, 2:30. This one over here is 300 feet long and a blue one. We're not sure who owns it. It's brand new. The police boats are holding everybody up because there's the last of the warships, the Navy ships, is going to be leaving here. This is the USS Cole. You can see it, the gray, smaller boat to the right of the Carnival Cruise Line. Ma'am, you need to have a seat, please. Pulling into the dock. There is a plank in the back. We're going to make you walk the plank when you stand up. All right, stop number five. Some paddle boaters over here. Out for a Mother's Day swim, looks like. And then wave at the nice folks over there. The large house with the big gazebo on the left was originally built by August Bush, Van Heiser Bush. The lights on the dock are Bud lights. $26, you want Jay Leno, okay. That house was sold to a Canadian reality TV star about a year ago for about $13 million, so all written up in the local newspaper. And that house is over 50 years old. Well, for the age, the location, and the history, it was a pretty good deal. Anybody remember Lucille Ball and Desi Arnaz? House with the white roof over there in the American flag was theirs. And Andy Griffith from Mayberry used to live in the house that was on that empty lot. Somebody's building a new mansion there. So. Thank you. This is stop number 7 coming up. There's a restaurant up here called Bahia Cabana. Gives you 10% discount with your auto taxi ticket. And also is the home of the 7 o'clock happy hour, 7 a.m. Big Nolte used to hang out here and he wanted to start early, so they started the 7 a.m. happy hour for him. So if you're out doing your power walking and you want to restore some calories, this is the place to do it. Johnny Weissmiller, one of the old original Tarzans, used to hang out here too. And they have a plaque on one of the bars in his honor. Right across the street is the south end of the Lauderdale Beach. First chance to get off and go walk in the sand for you. Everybody, please stay seated. All right, stop 7, folks. Fort Lauderdale, a lot of activities. You can rent jet skis and small motorboats. You can go parasailing. You can hang out there at Bahia Cabana and just enjoy the water traffic going back and forth. This is the Las Olas Boulevard Bridge here that we're going to pass under. This is the site of the original bridge to connect the mainland and barrier island many years ago. It was a wooden swing bridge. So if it was still in place, the captain would have to drop me off. I'd have to crank it open. He pulled the boat through and I'd have to crank it closed. So I'm glad it's gotten a little more modern around here. This is the fourth bridge at this location. This one opens on the quarter hour and three quarter hour. So just so you know, these bridges do not open on demand or on schedule. Either hour and half hour or quarter and three quarter. If you're captaining one of these big boats that needs a lift, you know what the schedule is. And you can pretty well time it from one bridge to the other. Thank you. somebody told you earlier in the day, the all the foreign flags on the backs of these yachts are registered offshore of the U.S., usually in a lot of Caribbean islands. And they're registered there basically to dodge taxes, for lack of a better tax explanation. You register off in one of the islands for a very reasonable amount of money, and they don't have to pay luxury taxes. They can hire a foreign crew without paying workers' comp or Social Security. So it's top 8 around here on the other side. Everybody, please stay seated. Anybody getting off at stop 8? No? Yeah, you guys getting off at stop 8? Okay, just stay seated until we get up on the dock, and then we'll help you off safely. And thank you in advance for any tips you might leave in our jars. If you enjoy the trip and the narration, we appreciate that. Our double decker over there, if you haven't seen it yet today. It has all the comforts of home. It has a bar, most importantly. and it has a toilet. So, I've had people get on there and ride for a week, and you know, have no reason to get off. Okay, stop 10 coming up to UTL and Merch State Park. Then everybody have a seat, please. We do have to. looking house here on the right used to be owned by Joe Namath. Joe Namath, the New York Jets football player, quarterback.
We're about to go under is Las Olas Bridge. That is the main stretch in Fort Lauderdale. That goes from our stop number one to our stop number eight. It takes us an hour for a taxi. Will take you 5 minutes by land taxi. Just in case you get stranded at stop number eight, we want to stay out here a little bit longer. Until about 5 minute taxi ride. Stops number 3 and 1. Over on our left, you see a for sale sign there on that house. That house belongs to a retired school teacher from Clearwater, Florida. He is what he decided to start a restaurant based off of short wine shorts, big fat, good chicken wings, and big smiles. They founded Hooters. Alright folks, we're about to pull into stop number 8. This is Beach Place, our most popular beach stop. Let's pull in here. I'm just going to need everybody to leave.